Once upon a time, before God created man, the O'Neill family's 53,000-acre Rancho Mission Viejo nestled serenely in South Orange County. Deer and cattle roamed the hills of this old rancho, which was part of the historic Rancho Santa Margarita de las Flores Spanish land grant. Del Sol Golf Course opened with a little help from Dad Miller, shown on the left. Mission Viejo reached a population of 30,000, and with the financial backing of Philip Morris, we began a $10 million construction project called Lake Mission Viejo. Our analysis showed this was very risky because we would have to sell homes for as much as $60,000 to justify this lake. What a gamble. The same year, ground was broken on our newly leased corporate offices. 77 dawned with a severe drought in Northern California. And even though water already in Southern California couldn't help, we still ran into a public relations dilemma when we tried to fill up our new lake. Here's how KNBC reported it in February of that year.
When we did the story yesterday, 35% to 40% of the water coming into the unfinished lake was from Northern California. But today, the Mission Viejo company decided voluntarily to stop using Northern California water, instead relying solely on water from the Colorado River. Did the company feel the action was necessary, or was the voluntary cutoff a public relations move? Here is what President Philip Riley said to that.
If the water is not going into the lake, I don't know how it's going to get up to Northern California, but it certainly seemed to us like an appropriate way to demonstrate our sympathy and understanding for those people who are truly not at fault. And there are many, many people in Northern California who are not to blame for their shortage of water at this time.
The good news was that homes were selling so fast, we held lotteries, like this one, at Vista del Lago. And in June 78, we finally opened Lake Mission Viejo. Guess who went for the first swim? And who caught the first fish? That year, Mission Viejo Mall also opened.
The California Promise. It's kind of like a promise fulfilled.
Harvey Stern dreamed up the California Promise campaign for Mission Viejo several years ago. That was during the adolescence of this planned community. Now it's nearly 20 years old. Mission Viejo is what developers call a mature community, 75% complete, with nearly 60,000 residents. Before its conception, this supposed cradle of the good life in South Orange County was desert. A 10,000-acre chunk of desert. That's about two-thirds the size of Manhattan.
The concept of taking that land and developing it into a full-scale community, ultimately with 30,000 families, as well as probably well over a million trees, where there might have been a dozen or two dozen trees to start with, is pretty staggering.
But a million trees later, the concept seems to be a staggering success.
You know, I'm from originally from South Africa, and I was back there last year, and I showed real estate people what a picture of Mission Viejo. They have these big posters, and they couldn't believe that it was man-made, man-created, you know, and they just don't have anything like that.
It's just not the people who are the three-piece suits who out into the Doris Day suburbs. There's a little bit more than that out here.
But you can't help expect, just a little, to see Doris take a dive off that dock. Or maybe see her bring the little ones to the beach.
We're close to everything. That we have a mall real close and everything, and it's just nice being here.
It never gets boring?
No, never, 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 because we have everything right down here that we need.
Go swimming.
What?
You can ride boats.
Seem just too good to be true?
It is true. Just ask me.
Hey, you can also fish too.
Still, there are some priceless elements missing from Mission Viejo. Some you might not even think you'd miss till you live in a perfectly planned community.
There are pros and cons to, you know, master plan communities, you know. In a way, you'd like to see a sleazy, you know, Armenian restaurant down on the corner or something like that in some of these places, which you just don't get.
Like it or not, planned communities may well fill up much of what can be filled up in Southern California.